Hello, everybody. My name is Kamal Siddiqui. I'm the director for the Center for Excellence in Journalism in Karachi, IIA. हमने एक study launch कर रहे हैं आज उसकी report, and this study relates to counseling of journalists. ये पहली study of its kind है पाकिस्तान में, और इसमें हमने क्या किया है over the past 3 years based on the experience that we have had in terms of counseling. We've counseled over 100 journalists. And based on that, this study was just conducted. इस पर आज हम report लॉन्च कर रहे हैं. Report हम separately release कर रहे हैं, but मैं discussion के लिए I've asked Dr. Asha Bedar, who is a clinical psychologist by profession, and she has been the person who has put together the findings of the study. So first of all, welcome Dr. Asha, and thank you for all the good work you've done for our profession. And if we could start off by asking you, Dr. Asha, ke ye study, how was this done? I mean, what went into it, and how did you do this?
Yeah. Thank you so much for having me here for the discussion, and I'm very pleased that ye report jo hai ye release ho rahi hai, because ispe kafi milke main bhi NCEJ collaborative kism ki report thi jo pichle 3 saal se jo kaam chal raha tha. So I'm very glad to finally be able to actually speak about what we did. इसमें बहुत सारी कंसिडरेशंस थी जब हम इस पर कर रहे थे, जो हमारी डिस्कशंस भी इस पर रही थी, बिकॉज आई थिंक हमारे लिए 2-3 चीज़ें इंपॉर्टेंट थी. एक तो ये दैट वी वांटेड द इंफॉर्मेशन आउट देयर, यू नो, अराउंड व्हाट जर्नलिस्ट्स एंड मीडिया वर्कर्स आर एक्चुअली एक्सपीरियंसिंग. क्या इश्यूज़ हैं, क्यों स्ट्रेस है जिस पर हम बात कर रहे हैं, वो तो वी नो, आई ब्रीफली मैंशन दैट. लेकिन इम्पैक्ट क्या है, उनके काम को किस तरह से इम्पैक्ट कर रहा है, उनको इंडिविजुअली किस तरह से इम्पैक्ट कर रहा है. सो वी वॉन्टेड टू प्रोवाइड स्नैपशॉट ऑफ दैट, यू नो, अ रियल अंडरस्टैंडिंग. लेकिन उसके साथ साथ हमें बहुत सेंसिटिव भी होना पड़ रहा था, बिकॉज कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी वॉज अ, यू नो, समथिंग दैट वी फेल्ट वॉज द मोस्ट क्रिटिकल फैक्टर, बोथ इन टर्म्स ऑफ द काउंसलिंग सर्विस इटसेल्फ एंड इन दिस रिपोर्ट. क्योंकि एज इट इज़ जो मेंटल हेल्थ प्रोफेशन है पाकिस्तान में, जो इंडस्ट्री है, इट इज़ एन अनरेगुलेटेड इंडस्ट्री. सो आई थिंक वो कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी के कंसर्न वैसे भी होते हैं. And for a counseling service to be effective, that is one of the most important things for people to be able to trust ki hum unke paas ja rahe hain, hamari information ke sath kya kiya jayega, isko baad mein jaake kis tarah se use kiya jayega, hame kya help milegi. So one of the things that we kept in mind, and jo methodology ko jis cheez ne inform kiya tha, was, you know, how can we maintain confidentiality and still be able to get this information out there,
right? Of course.
तो विच इज़ वाई हमने सिर्फ जो क्लाइंट्स आ रहे थे उनका डेटा यहाँ पे नहीं इस्तेमाल किया. ऑफकोर्स हम वो भी बीच में वो इन्फॉर्म कर रहा है स्टडी को, देर नो आइडेंटिफाइंग इन्फॉर्मेशन बीइंग यूज्ड, बट इट इज़ बीइंग यूज्ड एज कलेक्टिव इन्फॉर्मेशन. बट एट द सेम टाइम वी ऑल्सो डिड फोकस ग्रुप डिस्कशंस विद जर्नलिस्ट्स हु वर नॉट क्लाइंट्स बट जनरली इन कराची, एंड वी डिड इन डेप्थ इंटरव्यूज, और एक क्वेश्चनेयर भी यूज हुआ था. एंड वी फेल्ट दैट वाज इफेक्टिव कि हम 4 डिफरेंट डेटा सोर्सेज को इस्तेमाल करें to actually tap into what the issues are, कि उसमें प्रिंट भी हो, उसमें हमारे जो हैं वो इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मीडिया का भी आए. सो ऑल काइंड ऑफ मीडिया वर्कर्स के परस्पेक्टिव वी वॉन्टेड टू गेट इन टू दिस, एंड ऑफकोर्स द एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ द, यू नो, द काउंसलिंग सर्विस इटसेल्फ, क्या इशूज थे, क्या ट्रिगर्स थे. सो दैट वॉज रियली हाउ इट ऑल स्टार्टेड, एंड वॉज कंडक्टेड ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ नंबर ऑफ मंथ्स, एंड देन ऑल द थीम्स वर सिंथेसाइज्ड एंड द क्वेश्चनेयर्स आल्सो एनालाइज्ड.
So, Dr. Asha, there's a report based on 600 hours of counseling, more than 100 journalists from all over Pakistan, mostly from Karachi. But let's start that in terms of the study, and then when you said that, what are the main findings? Before we go into that, the issue of trust, journalists coming in, journalists, वैसे हमारी जो industry है, as you know, it's in a crisis. And then there are lots of pressures. जो हमारा profession है उसमें इतने pressures हैं in terms of the kind of work. So when you started off, if you could just share a bit about when this started, this counseling, how did it take off, how did people initially react to it, before we go into the findings.
Yeah, the findings. Yeah. Now that's important, because like I said, with confidentiality and trust वाला जो आपने भी point यहाँ पे किया है was इसके बगैर तो ये चल ही नहीं सकता था, ना सेंटर चल सकता था, ना ये स्टडी हो सकती थी. एंड आई थिंक इट वॉज, आई मीन, इट वॉज अ ग्रेट ऑनर दैट जर्नलिस्ट केम एंड दे डिड ट्रस्ट, बट इट वॉजंट एन ईजी प्रोसेस. यू नो, शुरू में आई रिमेंबर जब शुरू हो रहा था तो जाके इंट्रोड्यूस करना टू वेरियस, यू नो, चैनल, न्यूज पेपर जाके, यू नो, एंड वहाँ पे भी कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी को स्ट्रेस करना, बिकॉज वाई शुड समवन ट्रस्ट मी, वाई शुड समवन हु इज स्ट्रगलिंग विद इश्यूज गो अप टू अ स्ट्रेंजर, ठीक है उनकी नाम है डिग्री है जो भी आप वहाँ पे चले जाएं एंड देन स्टार्ट टेलिंग देयर यू नो टॉकिंग अबाउट देयर पर्सनल इश्यूज एंड स्पेशली इन एन इंडस्ट्री जहाँ पे विच रन्स ऑन न्यूज विच रन्स ऑन इंफॉर्मेशन पासिंग राइट तो वहाँ पे सो उसमें ये भी डिस्कशन कीजिए हम कहाँ पे सेंटर रखेंगे कहाँ पे लोग आ सकेंगे जहाँ पे दे नॉट बम्पिंग इनटू पीपल फ्रॉम देयर वर्क किस तरह से एक क्लाइंट के बाद दूसरे क्लाइंट आएंगे और वो आपस में नहीं मिलेंगे देयर वाज अ लॉट ऑफ थॉट प्रोसेस एंड अ लॉट ऑफ लर्निंग दैट वेंट इनटू इट आल्सो
लर्निंग बिकॉज़ दिस वाज द फर्स्ट ऑफ इट्स काइंड
बिकॉज़ इट्स द फर्स्ट ऑफ इट्स काइंड एंड आल्सो बिकॉज़ पाकिस्तान में मेंटल हेल्थ एंड थेरेपी आर न्यू एरियाज दे आर स्टिल रिलेटिवली न्यू एरियाज यस 20 साल पहले से बेहतर है बट अभी भी Again, trust establish करना in itself was a task.
Of course.
So, जब आते भी थे clients, अगर कोई आ भी गए trust करके, sometimes sessions में the first two or three sessions were very often just developing a rapport with me, कि वो trust करें, trust किस तरह से होगा, किस तरह से हम उनको forms अगर fill करवा रहे हैं, क्या होगा उस information के साथ, knowing right, that the right. names were not going to go into any analysis. फिर मेरे साथ, you know, to even seek, they establish a relationship, could they open up to me? क्योंकि आपकी क्वालिफिकेशन एक और चीज़ होती है बट नॉट एवरीबडी कैन डेवलप अ रिलेशनशिप द सेम वे एंड एज क्विकली सो अ लॉट ऑफ द टाइम वेंट इनटू जस्ट ट्रस्ट बिल्डिंग एंड दैट इज अ वेरी फंडामेंटल पार्ट ऑफ साइकोथेरेपी एंड काउंसलिंग कि आप जो ट्रस्ट बिल्डिंग करते हैं
ऑफ कोर्स एंड डू यू फील दैट विद जर्नलिस्ट्स इट वाज हार्डर और डू यू थिंक इट वाज
इट्स हार्ड जनरली बट यस आई थिंक बिकॉज ऑफ द नेचर ऑफ द इंडस्ट्री इन सम वेज यस बिकॉज वो अ लॉट ऑफ द टाइम आई रिमेंबर शुरू में जब क्लाइंट्स आते थे दे वुड आस्क मी के you know, ये information कहाँ पे और अभी अगर हमारे निकल गया ये बात अगर निकल गई तो I might lose my job या लोग बात करेंगे शुरू में इस तरह की भी चीज़ें हुई where some journalists came and they were actually very open and then they went and told people at work it worked well for some people and for some people it created problems उन्होंने जाके जब कहा कि जो डॉक्टर आशा हैं और मैं थेरेपी में जा रहा हूँ एंड पीपल वर टॉकिंग अबाउट इट कि जी ये थेरेपी में है और ये है बिकॉज इट्स स्टिल समथिंग दैट इज अ टबू
राइट
In Pakistan, very much so. So, उस पे काफी काम करना पड़ा था.
Interesting. I would imagine that, given our profession and given the fact that it's a very close profession and everybody knows each other, so I would imagine ke. Anyway, if we come to the findings, Dr. Asha, if you could tell us a bit about.
Yeah.
It,
so. Okay. Just to connect the two things, एक बहुत जल्दी से एक चीज कहना चाह रही थी कि even though trust was an issue and it took a while. One thing I will say is, and I think वो report जब launch जब करेंगे तो उसकी findings इसमें भी चीज आएगी. We did have a lot of people come in, however, because the word of mouth really matters. You know, तो शुरू में आप जब trust नहीं करते, तो जब लोग बात करते हैं, जो लोग जाके अपने friends को या close circle में जाके बात कर रहे थे, openly नहीं भी कर रहे थे, तो we had a you know bookings sometimes you know booked up for months in advance.
Okay.
So it was very well received, which I think also to me indicates कि इसकी need इतनी ज़्यादा है कि when you do it properly, when you do consider ethical professional standards so you can actually run it well so it's not as though ke pakistan mein kyunki is pe baat nahi hoti to ye ho nahi sakta
right.
in fact bookings kai dafa clients ko milti nahi thi regularly because there was such a huge need and we didn't have enough resources to actually be able to cater to those needs all the time
Dr. Asha, do you think in terms of our profession journalists this profession the need for counseling is higher than other professions in terms of the kind of pressures we face
I'm not sure if I could say higher, but I think it's certainly one of the professions jahan pe pressures itne zyada hain. You know, similarly, kuch helping professions mein hote hain, jaise you know, doctors hain. But anyone exposed to, I guess, stress, trauma, logon ki misery, and a lot of journalism is that. And you know, when I started talking to journalists, jo sessions mein bhi aa rahe the, and then when I was conducting the data collection, jab main kar rahi thi, one of the things really that stood out for me was that how much of the work that you all do. Is to do with sad and difficult and stressful things that are happening in people's lives.
Right.
Disasters hain, ya fires ho rahi hain, ya kuch aap report kar rahe hain, ya politics bhi agar kar rahe hain, toh usmein bhi there is just constant pressure. So it's not just the industry itself jiske issues chal rahe hain, but so much of it is the content that you deal with.
Achha, of course, that's true.
So the actual thing, so you know, people would talk to me and, you know, maine ye cover kiya, maine ye story ki, yes, unki adrenaline bhi wo ho rahi thi, wo enjoy bhi kar rahe the. A lot of people come into the profession for that. And if I was to, you know, write down ke kitni dafa lafz ishq and passion use hua journalist jab wo baat kar rahe the, that is why a lot of people come in. they're motivated, they're passionate about it, and they want to deal with it. लेकिन कहीं ना कहीं पे जाके वो आपको इम्पैक्ट तो फिर भी करता है ना, बिकॉज़ आई एम वेरी ह्यूमन, सो यू कैन वांट टू हेल्प, यू कैन वांट टू गो इन, बट अल्टीमेटली जो आप कंटेंट है डे इन डे आउट, आपके फ्रेंड्स भी वही हैं, सो वो भी एक होता है,
राइट? बड़ा मसला है कि हाँ, जर्नलिस्ट के फ्रेंड्स, बिकॉज़ ऑफ द टाइमिंग्स आई थिंक दैट वी कीप, आई थिंक दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव दिस,
आप दो बजे बैठे हैं स्टोरी कर रहे हैं, या आपका चैनल है, यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द सेम थिंग, अब यहाँ पे ये हो गया, वहाँ पे ये हो गया, या ये वाली स्टोरी कवर कर रहे हैं, इट्स लाइक अ कॉन्स्टेंट थिंग. And then you throw in social media. So in the last 20, 15 years or so, ab ek wo ek additional constant exposure hai.
Additional stress bhi hai?
Additional stress bhi hai. Because now you don't get a break. Pehle bhi aapka social circle tha. Yes, aapke wo thi, but aap ghar chale jaate the. Whatever
and
time.
And you switch off.
And you switch off for that time.
Ab nahi hai.
So wo ek additional hai. Ki achha, industry ke apne issues hain, workplace ke individual apne issues hain. And then social media ke issues hain, content ke issues hain. And even the content, I feel, in some ways, over the last few years, has become more and more stressful because of social media. You know, so aap constantly dekh bhi rahe hain. You don't want to miss out on it. So I one of the things, jo main sunte, you know, I kept thinking about it when I was hearing them, ki there is no break. You have to be on top of the news. You can't miss out ki kisi ne agar ye kar diya, kisi aur ne aapse pehle break kar diya hai news. You know, how do you, you know, you know that you're going to be under pressure.
Very true.
So, WhatsApp pe aap hain. Kitne WhatsApp groups pe hote hain log. So, it's just constantly happening.
So you're saying that on the one hand, it is the job requirement, in the sense that we have to be on top of the news. On the other, it's the content, which is usually sad. So, these are two major factors that come into play.
Yeah. And the fact that I think for a lot of people, especially passion ki wajah se jo aate hain, it's also an addiction.
It is an addiction, of course. Huh? Journalism is an addiction.
It is. Anyway. News is an addiction. Journalism is an addiction.
Of course.
So, wo aapki apni personality and why you're drawn to this particular profession, which is both a helping factor and also
and
adds to the stress.
Of course. So, what are the findings? Aapne jo report ki, you were the person who worked on this along with my colleague Mahi Meher. So, tell us about the findings.
Yeah, I think for those days I was actually dreaming of all the, you know, data that was coming up, because there was so much information that was shared.
Right.
And it was so freely and so openly shared that it was actually very moving as well.
Achha.
Aur mujhe ye lagta tha ki, you know, I think maine Mahim se bhi kai dafa ye baat ki thi ki itna data aaya hai that if we wanted we could do another report on it. You know, we could actually collect a lot more. We had to focus on certain things, of course, ki ye day-to-day kya stresses hain. But there was a lot of information that was shared. And yes, we know why. We know industry mein kya ho rahe hain, kya changes ho rahe hain, layoffs ho rahe hain. We know workplace pe kya hai, you know, jo wahan pe jo management hai, unke kya issues hain. We know content hai. You know, some of that we know. But I think what we're not talking about so much, and jiske liye hum space nahi provide kar rahe, wo cheez study mein aayi hai, which is how it is impacting individual journalists, their works, their work, and their collective performance as well. And wo stress bahut different levels ka hai. You know, kai jagah pe it's just that day-to-day stress, which is also part of the job. And I hear that in usme bhi nikal ke aaya study mein, with some people saying that if you can't take stress, you can't be a journalist. And I hear that. I understand ki wo nature of the job hai is tarah ki.
Right.
But har ek ki stress ki ek limit to hoti hai as human beings. And of course, there is stress and then there is stress.
That's true.
You know, so wo day to day hai, and yes, some people work and you know, work better, in fact, under that stress, and that's why they're there. But when that stress starts to become more complex, jahan pe aapke depressive symptoms aana shuru ho jate hain, because there is so much helplessness, chahe wo industry ki wajah se ho, aap bar bar aapki salaries cut ho rahi hain, ya mil nahi rahi hain, ya layoffs ho rahe hain, ya aapke workplace related stresses hain, ya mulk ke halaat itne hain ki constantly aap wahi news report kar rahe hain.
True,
या जैसे कई दफ़ा होता है कि कोई एक क्राइम है, अगर वो रिपोर्ट हो रहा है, तो अब जैसे यू नो सेक्सुअल वायलेंस के क्राइम जब रिपोर्ट होने शुरू हुए, तो देयर वाज अ सीरीज, आई मीन देयर वाज अ टाइम वेयर एवरी डे ऑन द न्यूज़ देयर वाज अ यू नो रेप बीइंग रिपोर्टेड और यू नो चाइल्ड मर्डर बीइंग रिपोर्टेड. तो जो उस बीट पे जो काम कर रहे थे वो कॉन्स्टेंटली बीइंग एक्सपोज्ड टू इट, तो वो चीज़ें भी चल रही हैं. सो उसका जो टोल होता है, यू कीप गोइंग. सो इट्स नॉट एज़ दो दीज जर्नलिस्ट्स आर नॉट बीइंग एबल टू फंक्शन. वो भी थे, especially जो थेरेपी में आ रहे थे उसमें कुछ ऐसे लोग थे who were not being able to cope at all. So, you know, which is why I think they took that step despite the taboo, despite everything, to go for therapy. लेकिन जो बाकी सर्विस वगैरह में जो लोग आए थे, they were still functioning. तो वो तो ऑटो पे हम चलते रहते हैं और हम अपनी बॉडी को अब्यूज भी होने देते हैं कई दफा इन दैट प्रोसेस.
यस, सो व्हेन यू टॉक अबाउट ऑटो पे चलते रहते हैं, व्हाट डिड द फाइंडिंग से इन टर्म्स ऑफ व्हेन डू पीपल रियलाइज दे नीड हेल्प? आई थिंक
या इंपॉर्टेंट गुड क्वेश्चन, बिकॉज आई थिंक कई दफा इट इज व्हेन दे आर आइदर इन अ क्राइसिस सिचुएशन या जहां पे व्हेन दे फियर कि अच्छा आई एम गोइंग टू लूज माय जॉब.
Right.
उस वक्त तक दे कीप टेकिंग अ होल लॉट ऑफ स्ट्रेस एंड दैट वाज समथिंग दैट केम आउट, यू नो, डिप्रेशन भी हो रही है, फैमिली के साथ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स भी हो रहे हैं, बिकॉज ऑफ कोर्स वो ओवरलैप करता है, आप घर जाते हैं, आपकी पर्सनल लाइफ भी इफेक्ट होती है, बच्चे, फैमिलीज, यू नो, सम जर्नलिस्ट सेइंग कि मैं पता नहीं कब से कोई फैमिली का इवेंट नहीं यू नो कर पाया अटेंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस, सो इट्स टेकिंग इट्स टोल और वो चलता रहता है. देर आर सम हु यू नो विल कम इन बिकॉज दोज आर ट्रिगर्स फॉर देम कि मेरी पर्सनल रिलेशनशिप इफेक्ट हो रही है. But for a lot of them, it's until they actually realize they cannot function. Yeah, functioning itni zyada unki impede ho rahi hai. Health ke issues ho gaye. People talked about heart conditions, blood pressure ke conditions, migraine headaches. Doctor ke paas baar baar ja rahe hain, samajh mein nahi aa rahi hai. Doctors are saying ki bhai physically to kuch bhi nahi nikal ke aa raha. Aap psychiatrist ke paas jaye, psychologist ke paas jaye. So when they got to that point. And which is why, for me, this program and the study is so important. Because why should you get to that point before you realize that I'm burning out?
That's true.
Or that I am experiencing symptoms of trauma. ठीक है, हमारे PTSD के cases इसमें इस तरह से नहीं निकले diagnosis, because I think Karachi में किसी ज़माने में था, but अभी वो इस तरह से they're not constantly dealing with it. You know, it's a very different study जो Peshawar में की थी उन्होंने.
Right.
Because of course for terrorism वगैरह के. But trauma फिर भी है. Not every trauma manifests as a disorder.
That's true.
You know, trauma के और भी effects होते हैं. So why get to that point? And unfortunately, वो avenues यहाँ पे नहीं हैं. In their workplaces or other places where they can actually pick up on their stresses before they get to that point.
Of course.
And when they do talk about it, the general attitude is, dear, this is part of your work.
Do you get this feeling that journalists also feel that by calling out and saying, so they're actually not being faithful to their profession in some way, they're supposed to be taking the stress, and if they're not, ये होता है क्या?
To an extent there is guilt, and जब जो करते भी हैं, जो बात करते भी हैं, sometimes that's the attitude that they get also,
right,
because
right.
you know others may have been coping in a different way, या उनका काम different है, या वो different you know उनकी coping techniques different हैं, so जो करते हैं बात, yes sometimes they do, because इसमें एक और चीज भी है which I want to mention, you know काम के stresses and content तो है. But because you're human beings, there are also things happening at home.
At home, of
course. बचपन के traumas, या आपके बचपन के stresses, and sometimes they come together. So just because one person in the same work situation is not feeling depressed, doesn't mean that you can't. Because aap individuals hain, aapki coping different hai, aapki zindagi, aapki circumstances are different. So when they talk about it, they may not understand other people. So wo bhi put down kar rahe hote hain, wo khud bhi guilt kar rahe hote hain. And yes, you're right, wo bhi hota hai ki bhai, I chose this, so now I have to somehow, you know, just deal with it. And an actual very severe depression, you know, at times major depression ke symptom nazar aate the when people would come in. And I saw that, and it came out also in the focus groups and the interviews as well. Physical symptoms, depression ke symptoms, anxiety ke bahut zyada symptoms.
Okay.
And a lot of that was related purely to work itself. You know, ye karna hai, jaldi karna hai, what if I lose my job, what if mujhe salary nahi mili, ghar kaise chalega, dusri jobs available nahi hai, taking major job cuts in terms of, you know, aap wahan pe the, lekin aap wahan pe aa gaye because job karni hai, politics hai, you know, all these kinds of things jo chalti hain wahan pe, different kisam ki interferences chalti hain industry mein aur kaam pe. So, there's all of that. But the impact was that the anxiety at times was severe enough for it to affect their day-to-day functioning. So, jo log motivate hoke bhi aa rahe hote the, wahan pe jab kaam pe aa rahe hain, some of them, you know, could not cope and they were job hopping. Ke nahi yahan pe ye workplace ka hai, but the issue was actually them and their own anxiety, not necessarily the workplace.
That's
wo bhi tha, of course.
That's interesting.
But so nahi pa rahe, a lot of them self-medicating.
Right. Okay.
Because of that, because you know, psychiatrist ke paas nahi ja rahe, ya time nahi milta. Because wo bhi to hai, aapki timing, aapki shift is tarah ki hai. That is also why some people couldn't make it to therapy regularly, because hamara to wo regular, you know, 9 to 5 aapka time hai, lekin aapki shift hoti hai us waqt, ya aap us waqt so rahe hote hain, because aapki raat ko 12 baje shift start hoti hai. So they were not being able to do a lot of the day to day things that keep us going, you know, family, people, friends, socializing. These are the things jisse ke log, you know, they kind of energize you, they refuel you.
That's true.
So, वो भी उनको नहीं मिल रहा था. अपनी ट्रीटमेंट और अपनी हेल्थ के लिए भी वो फोकस नहीं कर पा रहे थे.
What about Dr. Ashwin, we talk about women journalists. Thoda sa if you could talk, what are your, in terms of your findings when it comes to women journalists, what did you come up
with? Lekin the thing is, we know that discrimination and harassment is a reality in many workplaces and everywhere, right? We know that. I think, so that was something that came out isme bhi, ke kuch were workplace specific, kuch were industry related factors, of course, the sexual harassment ki bhi cheezen thi, and saath saath discrimination bhi jis tarah ki hoti hai. And it is, I mean, yes, there are a lot more women in journalism, you know, perhaps than there used to be. I don't know statistics kya hai, but a lot of women coming in, a lot of young women coming into it. Lekin bahut zyada ke jagah pe restrictive environment ki wajah se, a lot of women felt, again, trapped. Ke baat karenge, to kya hoga? Jobs pehle hi kam hai. And particularly, jab aap kisi ek position mein pahunch gaye hain, where otherwise work-wise things are good, so then you don't want to speak up. That happens everywhere, I think.
Course,
you know, it's not just about this particular industry. But certainly that came out for a lot of women. Ke, achha, kis tarah ki aapko beats di ja rahi hai, kis tarah ki aapko, you know, kaam diya ja raha hai, aapse expectations kya hai, bosses ki kya hai, colleagues ki kya hai. And very often you're in an environment which is a primarily male-dominated environment as well. Wahan pe aur issues hai. And then when you're in a male-dominated environment, to phir aapko, ke dafa you're, you know, they themselves are expected, expecting themselves ke bhai hame yahan pe prove karna hai ke, you know, this is not just
so they have to go an extra mile as well,
so extra effort bhi aap saath saath kar rahe hain, uska alag stress hai. And then is type ki situation bhi, of course, ke aap late night bhi kaam kar rahe hain, and if you're not, you know, either you're not given those beats because you're a woman, or you're given those beats and you have to obviously then perform your role, and say aapki family life and ghar pe jo situation ban sakti hai, so overlap bahut zyada usme rehta hai. But certainly there were a lot of women who were coming into, you know, whether it was therapy, yahan jo survey mein bhi nikla tha, that I think harassment is quite an issue that needs to be, quite a big issue that needs to be addressed. Halanki hamara law hai, but kis had tak wo implement ho raha hai aur kis had tak wo understand kiya ja raha hai, I think that is something that is certainly missing. But a gender component was a very strong one that emerged in the study.
What about in the findings that you had, did you find something that surprised you? Something that was out of the ordinary? You've been in this profession for a very long time, so anything that you found that was not what you'd expected, and it was specific to this study?
Specific to journalists and study, okay. I'm not sure if it would be a complete surprise as such, but what I would say is, I think, jo aapne ek baat bhi ki thi, I think that a lot I found people were coming at a point where they were breaking down.
Okay.
So, and I think for mainstream mein ye hota hai ki you get those as well, but you get a lot of people who are coming in for self-exploration, they want to understand themselves better, yeah, you know, they can sort of pick up the signs a little bit. And I think because journalists are so used to telling other people's stories, ek toh, and again, also wohi wala factor ki bhai aapne baat nahi karni, you're supposed to be able to take it. So they have a lot more of a, I think, a higher threshold for stress, which is both good and bad. That's the irony of it. कि आपका थ्रेशोल्ड ज्यादा होता है बिकॉज यू हैव टू कोप.
दैट्स ट्रू.
बट जब वो थेरेपी में आते हैं तो इट्स बीन इयर्स एंड इयर्स एंड इयर्स ऑफ पैटर्न्स बीइंग क्रिएटेड, चाहे वो कॉन्फ्लिक्ट के हैं, एंड देन थेरेपी में उनको एड्रेस करना, उनको अनडू करना, यू नो, दैट्स अ चैलेंज दैट दे देन फेस, बिकॉज आप 20 साल से यू बीन फंक्शनिंग इन अ सर्टेन वे. सो यस, आप सेल्फ अवेयरनेस करते हैं, विच इज द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ थेरेपी, यू नो, इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द एक्चुअल टेक्निक्स एंड उसका क्या बेनिफिट होता है, यू नो, इट्स जस्ट अंडरस्टैंडिंग योर सेल्फ. ठीक है, आप, यू कैन लव योर प्रोफेशन, यू कैन बी पैशनेट अबाउट योर प्रोफेशन, बट यू कैन ऑल्सो रिकग्नाइज एंड एक्नॉलेज कि उसके क्या क्या स्ट्रेसेज एंड इश्यूज हैं, हाउ इट्स अफेक्टिंग यू, एंड देन जाके हाउ डू यू चेंज एंड एक्चुअली चेंज योर थॉट प्रोसेसेस, योर बिहेवियर, बिकॉज आप अपने इर्द गिर्द लोगों को तो चेंज नहीं कर सकते, राइट? यू कैन वर्क ऑन योर सेल्फ, बट आप उसी इंडस्ट्री में हैं, वही आपके कॉलीग्स हैं, वही आपके इर्द गिर्द लोग हैं.
सो हाउ डू मैनेज हमारा जो प्रोफेशन है उसमें as a reporter, you're not supposed to be a participant. I think that's one of the problems, Kailin, this is part of our job, okay, you can't be part of the story.
Yeah.
And you're looking at things, you're absorbing them and then telling them, I think that also plays a part.
Yeah.
But up to humne jo baat hai ki, we've talked about the findings. Let's talk a bit about how therapy helped.
Yeah.
Tell, if you could share some stories, jahan aap laga ke ye service helped people, or if you could... Tell us those.
Yeah, I think there were a lot of those in the sense that, you know, I think when we talk करते भी थे एंड क्लाइंट फीडबैक भी लेते थे एंड बात भी जब करते थे आई थिंक अ लॉट ऑफ दैट इमर्ज्ड एंड सम ऑफ इट वाज ऑफ कोर्स माय ओन ऑब्जर्वेशंस एज वेल यू नो पीपल वुड कम इन समटाइम्स इन दैट वेरी इमोशनली यू नो देयर वाज एंग्जायटी देयर वाज नर्वसनेस लेकिन एक रॉ एक इमोशनल आपकी स्टेट होती है जब आप आते हैं यू नो यू डोंट क्वाइट नो व्हाट टू एक्सपेक्ट फ्रॉम थेरेपी सो सम पीपल वुड कम एंड सिट एंड नॉट क्वाइट नो व्हाट टू से कैसे आप पूछेंगे क्वेश्चंस या मुझे करनी है देन सम पीपल वुड कम एंड टॉक अबाउट इट इंडिविजुअल्स का बहुत डिफरेंट होता है बट सर्टनली जब वो बात करना शुरू होते थे तो एक तो ये जस्ट बीइंग एबल टू टॉक लेबल देयर इमोशन टॉक अबाउट व्हाट दे वर गोइंग थ्रू तो उसमें तो बहुत डिफरेंस नज़र आता था बट ठीक है आपने लेबल भी कर लिया आपने बात भी कर ली अल्टीमेटली यू वांट टू सी अ चेंज
ऑफ कोर्स
इन योर सेल्फ अपना इंडस्ट्री को कर सकते हैं ना अपनी वर्क प्लेस को चेंज कर सकते हैं बट अ चेंज इन योर सेल्फ एंड आई थिंक उस तरह की केसेस तो काफ़ी ज़्यादा हैं यू नाइट बी एबल टू यू नो टॉक अबाउट पीपल हु डू दैट जहाँ पे यू नो सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल एंड दिस इज नॉट जस्ट वन पर्सन बट पीपल हु केम इन विद issues of anger and okay. Now anger is one of those emotions jo bahut sare emotions ko cover karta hai it's not just anger itself right anger can be a cover for your sadness it can be a cover for your worry and it comes out as anger and usme bhi gender dimension agar main dekhu to for men particularly because we had more men approaching which was interesting because men are usually mainstream mein aap dekhe to more resistant to therapy than women are जब वो एक सर्विस मिली उनको एक कॉन्फिडेंशियल तो दे एक्चुअली फ्लॉक्ड टू इट बिकॉज दे वर रियलाइजिंग की वो हेल्थ को फैमिली को किस तरह से उनको इफेक्ट कर रहा है एंड काम पर्टिकुलरली फॉर इफेक्टिंग देयर वर्क फॉर मेन दैट वाज अ मेजर ट्रिगर यू नो कि आपको जब डर है कि यू गोइंग टू लूज योर जॉब एंड यू गोइंग टू लूज योर इनकम इन एन ऑलरेडी फ्रेजाइल वर्क एनवायरनमेंट
ऑफ कोर्स
सो देन अ लॉट ऑफ मेन वर कमिंग सो एंगर इशू वाज समथिंग दैट अ लॉट ऑफ मेन प्रेजेंटेड विद कि कॉलीग्स के साथ लड़ाइयाँ हो रही हैं बॉसेस के साथ लड़ाइयाँ हो रही हैं घर पे झगड़े हो रहे हैं एंड जस्ट स्ट्रगलिंग टू अंडरस्टैंड कि यू नो ये भी अनफेयर है ये भी अनफेयर है बहुत सारी चीज़ें जो हैं वो इनजस्टिस है सो बीइंग एबल टू सेपरेट कि यू नो यस देयर इज इनजस्टिस यस ऑल ऑफ दीज थिंग्स आर हैपनिंग आपके इंडस्ट्री के भी इशूज़ हैं But what is your, what are the emotions that are hiding behind that anger? And how can you at an individual level deal with them?
Right.
So self-awareness wala part.
Take
care. Then just labeling and understanding your emotions wala part. And then reframing how you think about your anger. So for example, I had this person who came in and I remember he was extremely angry, you know, when he came in therapy. And wo pehla aur dusra session, pehle session mein to I think itna nahi, but dusre teesre session mein when he opened up, the whole therapy session was him yelling. Okay, yeah. So I almost became like, you know, I was representing his office, his boss, the industry, his wife, everyone. So there was a lot of anger and I could feel the pain behind that anger. Mm. And it was probably the only time where he could come and actually do all that. Say ki ye bhi hai aur ye bhi hai aur main kya karunga. And at the end of it, I remember jab 3-4 sessions ho gaye, you know, he was able to express it. He was crying. He was able to express his vulnerability and understand ke, you know, ye anger hai, yes, it's there for a reason, but mujhe ab function karne ke liye kya karna hai. So we worked on specific anger techniques. We worked on him getting a break from his work, kahin pe wherever he could manage that break, even choti choti cheezein. Because kabhi kabhi humare mind mein perfect, ideal lifestyle hoti hai, right? Ki yun karenge, phir hum chutti pe jayenge, phir hum is waqt ghar aayenge, फिर हम हर महीने ये वाली छुट्टी करेंगे एंड जब वो हमारा स्कीमा डजंट वर्क आउट द वे वी वांटेड टू देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ फ्रस्ट्रेशन सो अ लॉट ऑफ थेरेपी इज अबाउट रीथिंकिंग एंड आल्सो थिंकिंग ऑफ अल्टरनेटिव वेज ऑफ अचीविंग द सेम थिंग जो शायद ये लाइन इस तरह नहीं होगी बट वो इस तरह होगी
right.
या
right.
आपकी लाइफ में जिस तरह से आपने पहले की है वो शायद उस तरह से ना हो बट इट विल जस्ट बी अचीव डिफरेंटली एंड देयर इज अ लॉट ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस टू इट इनिशियली बिकॉज वी ऑल ग्रो अप विद दैट एंड देन इवेंचुअली वी रियलाइज सो reframing
right,
rethinking right. evaluating and sometimes just learning techniques how do you deal with anxiety what do you do with your sadness coping techniques ko enhance karna jo aap kar sakte hain individually
that's primary I should also remind my audience ki ye counseling service is still available it's very much we are still offering this service for those who are interested hamare web page pe jaake they can cej.edu.pk pe wo jaake they can always look it up डॉक्टर आशा टेल मी क्या फाइंडिंग्स की बात हुई हमने कि वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द सक्सेस स्टोरीज एज वेल वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द स्टडी इटसेल्फ एनीथिंग एल्स यू'ड लाइक टू पॉइंट आउट एनीथिंग यू थिंक दैट केम आउट दैट यू would like to highlight.
Yeah, I think just very briefly, I'll just say one thing. I think, you know, kabhi kabhi ek wo hamara perception wahi jo hota therapy ke, you know, it's for a particular kind of person, you know, which yes, young log aayenge ya women aayengi ya you know jinke paas time hota hai ya ye hota hai. This is a free service, it's of a confidential course. Service, and there is always a way in therapy to find something that works for you. So I think that is one thing jo itni diverse hamari jo client group tha.
Jee.
You know, chahe wo men, women, whatever gender, koi bhi age group, koi bhi kism ki media ke saath kaam kar rahe hain. The whole point of a therapist working with you that we will find a way that
point
works
way.
For you.
Of course. Yes.
So koi na koi alternative, koi na koi tarika directed by you, aapki circumstances ke mutabik. You know, not by me saying, bhai aap ye kar lein, aap yoga kar lein, aap walk pe chale jaye. That's not what therapy is. It's what works for you to manage your anger or your sadness or your anxiety or your communication and relationships with people.
For you
working
to improve
together.
Your quality of life.
Quality of life, and even if it means changing the way you're thinking, which is often a part of it, but work together
right.
and always find a way. So it's for anyone.
Hey, thank you, Dr. Asha. Thanks a lot for this.
Thank you.
First of all, for the report, putting together that, but also for putting in so many hours, being part of our project, I think. Thanks are due to DW that sponsored this whole Hamarjo Wellbeing Center. Hai. And I take quickly to also thank the counselors, jo hamare aur the, clinical psychologists, Dr. Asha Kelava, Manur Sheikh, Tabinda Afzal, and Zainab Bari. We'd like to thank them for the work that they've done and are doing. But if you could allow me to conclude, I'll just conclude on the fact that this issue is not going anywhere. I think the challenges are mounting for journalists. The pressures are mounting, the stresses are mounting. And it's not to do with young or old, or in which medium you are. I think younger people face stress as well. They face challenges. So in that sense, I think like Dr. Asha, the most important point when I asked her, she said that in our profession, when people reach breaking point, then they look for help. I think it's time we started looking at signs, whether in ourselves or in our colleagues, pointing them out so that we can give help prior to that point when it becomes a breaking point. So with that, I'll stop. Thank you, Dr. Asha.
Thank you.
Thank you to everybody. Thank you for and listening to and watching our show. Thank you very much.